Here comes the danger up in this club. When we get started, man, we ain't gonna stop. We gonna turn it out till it gets too hot. Everybody sing, hey, yo. Tell them turn it out till they can't no more. Let's get this thing shaking like a disco ball. This is your last one and a courtesy call. Everybody sing, hey, yo.
What's up, y'all? I'm back with another What If video. And for this, it's a little different. I'm bringing a new What If series. Why? Because ideas like to keep popping in my head, and I want to get it out as quickly as I can before I end up forgetting it. So, yeah. There was one person in the comments. It was a while ago. And they asked me to do a What If series of what if Naruto or what if Deku was in Data Live. Now, I didn't want to do Deku simply due to the fact that there was already someone who did Deku, and his series was already pretty good of it. Shadow King, yeah. Here he did Deku, and I think he did like an after story of it and everything. Now, I don't know if I want to do all that, but I just want to do my own version of it with Naruto in it. So, yeah. Let me know in the comments how y'all enjoy this. And, yeah. Like, goal for this is going to be keep it very simple. Like, 10. Just because, you know, this is the first one. I don't want me going too big. And so, yeah. With that being said, let's get into the what if. A little girl with blonde pink pigtails, held tight by a white ribbon, appeared at the door. Naruto, you're going to be late for school again, she said. Well, she didn't say it. She jumped in the air in an air kick position and delivered a meteor blow. Something inside Naruto woke up and single-handedly blocked her kick. Her second attempt at once, and placed her in a headlock. I can accept one thing in this life, was this girl, who was apparently my sister now. Hey, you should really knock that off. Every morning it's the same thing. Can I just get some sleep around here? Sorry, I promise I won't do it again, she said with a face that was incredibly cute. Damn, I can't stay mad at her. Don't worry about it. Go get ready. I'll make you some breakfast, Naruto said with a sigh. Although in fact he was quite eager to do it. He didn't know why, but the concept of family excited him. He made her some nice warm ramen, because a meal is not a meal for ramen. Alright. As I get the broth just right, I thought about how I should spend it here. I've been here for 6 months already, and so much has happened since then. The weirdest part was that everyone knew me by my name. I realized that I had friends who I had never seen before and a sister. In the beginning, I had assumed they'd all been there in my life, but a month ago, well, division started. They made me uneasy, although I couldn't tell anyone about it. And so in this one, Naruto, you know, he will keep on having flashbacks about his past here and there. But hey, cute little sister kick, I heard behind me. Sure enough, you know, his little sister's foot almost came at my head, but he reacted in time and avoided it. Ugh, that was too close for comfort. What's on the menu, Naruto? What's her name again? Katora? Katori? I think that's her name. I might have to check. Katori asked. Famous? world famous Ichiraku ramen, steaming hot, Naruto said. Yuck, don't you have anything else? And what's a Ichiraku anyways? I'm not going to keep cooking for you with that attitude. And I have you know, Ichiraku is the best. The best? My tone downgraded. Naruto's tone downgraded as he forgot what he was going to say. Anyways, what do you want? Of course you're not going to eat my ramen, a deluxe kids meal. And you're actually expecting me to make that. Of course not. I expect you to take me to a restaurant where I can get one. What? Are you serious? You little... Naruto started, but then she put on her cutest smile. No, absolutely not. I am not taking you to a... 23 minutes later. Kiss deluxe meal. I'm getting a kiss deluxe meal. Katori screaming excitedly. Yeah, she had gotten what she wanted. On the other hand, I needed to put up an anti-cuteness shield. She was just too good at manipulating me. What are you even excited about? I'm sure it pales in comparison to my delicious ramen, Naruto said playfully. Yeah, your ramen. Look, we're here. We're at the restaurant I'm supposed to take her to. Okay. Be good, Naruto said. I have school right now, but I'll pick you up after third period. Got it? Yeah. But you have to be here. Even if terrorists attack. Even if there's a space quake. Promise me. Of course I'll be here. Believe it, Naruto said as she disappeared into the restaurant. That was another thing about his new world. There was this kind of natural disaster that he never heard of before. A space quake. Pretty much for those who haven't seen Dead Alive, it's pretty much this occurrence that happens around every 30 years. And today made it no exception. Behind what caused them, you know, the one thing that we knew about them was there were always a black explosion like shape and a massive amount of destruction they left. Just think of it as a shooting star, but it can deliver the size of a meteor, pretty much. I really hope I don't have to come pick Katara up during one of these. Naruto thought, and a vision came up again, stopping him dead in his tracks. I saw a man in a black robe with red clouds. He had orange hair and completely purple eyes. He was making a field around himself that looked almost transparent, or like a transparent space quake, but not quite. As the vision ended, Naruto cursed himself. This was the fifth time this week. Then someone else came into view. A girl dressed in my school uniform with, you know, silver hair and looking in my way. You know, Naruto didn't know her or why she was staring at me like that, but I paid her no mind and I kept going towards my school. Today was going to be a great day, Naruto thought. And so, yeah, as he got into class, he was stopped again by the same girl. Her hair, which looked like it was made straight out of white metal, was one of her more, I would say, defining features, but it was far from being the only good one. Though her face was a few levels beyond cute, and she had an amazing body. She looked like a lot prettier version of... Dang it! I keep forgetting who that is. Anyway, why is this girl in my way? And I had to get to my seat. Hold up. Alright, I'm back. So I started to go around her. Naruto Uzumaki, she said in monotone. Huh? Me? Do we know each other? Ah, so you don't remember? She asked without changing her tone. And went to her seat. Talk about confusing. Hey man, I heard behind me. I knew who it was. Wait, hold up. Alright, I'm back. I knew who this was. Tomomachi. The guy who was supposed to be my friend ever since I got here, but I found it hard to believe. He looked like he was after something every time we came near. And I was sure as hell it was not giving it to him. I also knew that he was in the right about to kick me, but I intercepted his kick with one of my own. For some reason, I was good at martial arts like that. Bro, do you know who Toichi? He asked flustered. I don't know, but hey, back off a few inches, will you? I snapped when he invaded my comfort zone. Sorry. It's just that, well, she's a super genius. She gets perfect grades, even in PE. In fact, she ties with you on top of class in that subject. And she's also pretty. She has always been on the top three girls I want to date. Yeah. So what? Alright, I'm back. Oh, that was so scary. I thought I almost ended the freaking recording there. So, anyway, let me get back to what I was talking about. Yeah, right. Top three girl, my ass. I looked at her. She was on a desk next to mine, but if she heard anything Tomomachi said, she didn't show it. Naruto continued staring back at her like an idiot, as if that would solve anything. And he almost didn't notice when their teacher showed up to begin class. And so, yeah, you know, the teacher came in. And, you know, Naruto lost interest and got a strange feeling that he had never been a good student at school anyway. So he looked away and found the girl called Toichi looking his way. She didn't look happy or sad, just looking. Is there something the matter? He asked. She was starting to creep me out just a little. Not that I had the right to say anything, but I had been doing the same thing seconds earlier. No, she replied in monotone. In fact, I'm going to stop saying monotone because every time I say it, she says it right after that non-distinguishing voice of hers. Save it for rare occasions. When the class is done, Tonomachi got in my way, a lot closer than I would prefer to. Got any plans today? He asked, which left it clear that it was probably double meaning of that. Yeah, I'm going to pick up my sister at a restaurant. Oh, he said, looking disappointed. Hey, isn't she? Yeah, she is my sister. I just said that. Well, you know, maybe after that, you and I could. Then the spacequake alert sounded. Saved by the bell. We got in line in order to go to the shelters. Then I noticed that Toichi was running ahead of the class. We were almost to the shelter when I heard a deep voice. I never heard a voice so deep. It sounded somehow familiar. Besides, I know, well, I might say it's weird, but it sounded like the voice was coming from inside me. Do you know where that girl is? Or where that girl, small girl is? The voice said. Suddenly, I remember what I promised to pick up Kotori up, even if a spacequake. But surely she took him refuge. Even I wasn't so reckless to come to think of it. Maybe I was reckless enough to stay in place during a lethal event in order to keep a promise. Besides, I would be there. I would never back up on my word. And I wouldn't start now. So I took out a small device from my pocket. I took my phone in my pocket and checked the GPS where she was at. And, you know, she was at the entrance of the restaurant. And instantly Naruto ran out the building into to the street. And, you know, he was moving so fast that few seconds he saw red. Meaning everything literally turned red. As if he was watching tinted glass. And then that happened. He swore he became faster and faster. I thought I got to the restaurants faster than I expected. And started looking around for my sister. And, you know, he started calling out his sister name, but she was nowhere to be found. And he checked the GPS locator on his phone. Okay, I'm fairly new to this technology, but I was pretty sure that it said we would be standing in the same place. So where is she? And then I heard a loud boom. And second later, I was covered in blackness. The spacequake is happening. And it's happening around me. And so with that, I'm going to end it right there. And so, yeah. I know this is not the longest one I've done. But this is just a thing to do for right now. Simply because I couldn't think of any words to do today. Any ideas I had just felt trash to me. So, yeah. With that being said, leave a like, comment down below, subscribe. I'm on my road to 1K. And with that being said, I'm out. Peace. Yeah, I keep a tool on me if they got a screw loose. They messing with my big homie, they must be a damn fool. I buy me some jewelry, under pressure I stay round the clock, tone forward. Class clone back in high school. I'm in love with designers, bound to taste. Laying down the recliner, stay in place. And you know I keep a rocket, got a 40 in my pocket. Niggas say that I'm the plug, and I ain't talking sock. For your love, run the race, cockpit I drive. Detour out of space, never been so high. Used to feel in last place, but now I fly by. Dior on my way, pull the trigger, he's fried.